ask you a question. How many of you actually felt the difference in breathing or difficulty in breathing in last 1 or 2 months? Or irritation in eyes? So every year in winters we see a high level of pollution in Delhi. Delhi NCR is covered by a smog of blanket of smog. So first of all, let's talk about the air pollutants. There are multiple pollutants in the air, and the most harmful of them is PM2.5. So PM stands for particulate matter, and 2.5 is the unit, basically the diameter or the width of the particle. 2.5 micron. That's a width. Micron is like a measuring unit, like inch, millimeter, and that is very small. One particle is 30 times smaller than a human hair. So you can imagine how small it is. But personally, guys, we are not the worst in the world. We are number 6, Delhi. And out of 10 world's most polluted cities, 9 are in India. So let's talk about why winter pollution is very high in Delhi. The first reason is the low wind. So basically, there are multiple factors like climate activities, but today I will be talking about the geographical aspects, but not the man-made part. The first is the low wind. Guys, you know, Chennai is the automotive capital of India. It houses most of the manufacturing plants. Chennai is the third largest city in terms of number of vehicles on road after Delhi and Bangalore. Chennai and the neighboring districts of Tamil Nadu, it has coal power, fire plant, and multiple industries it has. Still, Chennai has a breathable air. But if you compare to Delhi, obviously we are seeing. So if you compare to Delhi, the wind speed in Delhi is much lower than the wind speed in Chennai. And if you see in Delhi itself, the wind speed in winters is 1/3 of wind speed in summers in Delhi. So there is low speed in Delhi, so that's the first reason. The second is a wearing fact. Well, I found it very confusing, but I'll try to simplify it as I could, if I could. In wearing fact, what happens is, Delhi is located at the northeast of Thar Desert, and it is at the southwest of Himalayas. So what happens when the wind arrives from the coastal area and bringing all the pollutant and dust along with it towards the along the Indus Ganga region. So what is the Indus Ganga region? This is the it covers the northern part from the west of Pakistan and towards the east of Bangladesh, and covers Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Haryana, and then West Bengal. So what happens is when the pollution is coming, when the wind is coming, bringing all the pollutants, it gets trapped just before Himalayas. So the air pressure pushes the air from one side, and it's not able to escape quickly from the other side. So what happens, all the pollutants, they get trapped in the Indus Ganga region. And if you see, all the 9 polluted cities in India, they lie in this region. Delhi, Varanasi, Patna, Faridabad, and Kanpur, two or three different cities. Third reason is the winter inversion. So what happens usually in the normal temperature, as you go above the ground level, the temperature decreases, right? And in that phenomenon, the pollutants will get mixed up in the upper layer of air. But in winters, what happens sometimes, this is inversion of this phenomenon. And near the ground level, there is the cool air. And above the cool air, there is a buildup of warm air layer, which acts as a layer. And the below layer, it is there only. And the pollutants, they get trapped. It's not able to move through this warm air layer. So that is one other reason. And if we talk about the dust is not coming from the India itself, from the Thar Desert. The dust could be coming from farther distance as well. For example, 2 years ago, in November 2017, when there was a high pollution, so it was estimated that 40% of the dust was coming from Middle East dust storm. And So guys, this winter pollution is not due to India. This is a global phenomenon which was first highlighted in London in 1952. So what happened that time? In November 1952, in 4 days of smog, around 10,000 people got killed. In 4 days and after that, in aftermath. So there was a death of around 10,000 to 12,000 people that time. Also, China is struggling with the same thing, especially in the northern cities. And India and China, they both together, it accounts for around half of the worldwide death due to air pollution. That comes to 20 lakhs death every year. So, to conclude my speech, well, we can't do anything about the global phenomenon, but we can definitely do about the man-made activities. As the developed cities, they have come up with these stricter air quality norms, and recently China, it has started cutting emissions from the industries and households. And these steps are, they are actually showing the positive results in China. Whereas we have just lost the sang-froid of our land, we are just focusing, we're just blaming the each other's parties. So that's the BJP job, or that's the other party's job, that's the panel work has to be done. And when there's a parliament meeting, only just 4 MPs turn up out of 29 MPs, and 1 MP was just caught having jalebis, who is an excavator. So I guess, that's it. Thank you.